fellow students of class 9, once again we come back to compound interest. This is a sum. If the simple interest on a sum of money for 3 years is rupees 225 and the compound interest for the same sum for 2 years is rupees 153, find the rate of interest and the sum. Now for this sum you need to relate to the previous video which has been posted. Previous video of compound interest, obviously. Now for this, the solution is simple interest of 3 years is rupees 225. Simple interest of 1 year is obviously 225 by 3, 75. Simple interest of 1 year is equal to compound interest of first year. We already know that, rupees 75. Compound interest of 2 years is given, rupees 153. Hence, compound interest of the second year is 153 minus compound interest of first year, that is 75. The answer is rupees 78. Now you see there's a difference between compound interest of second year and first year. CI2 minus CI1 is 78 minus 75, rupees 3. Now we know that CI2 minus CI1, that is the difference between the interest of two successive years in compound interest, is equal to the rate percent of compound interest of first year. So 3 is equal to r percent of 75, r we don't know, that we have to find out. That is the first question over here, find the rate of interest. So 3 is equal to r percent of 75, r is equal to 4%. Now once we find the rate, we have with us rate with us, then we have first year's compound interest. First year's compound interest is nothing but the simple interest of 1 year. Time is 1 year only, so I is equal to PRT by 100. From there, we are finding the sum of money. P is equal to rupees 1875. Now, this sum will generally come for 4 marks. Now, this part will carry 2 marks. This will carry 1 mark. And this will carry 1 mark. Now, if you are unlucky, then it might come for 3 marks. If it comes for 3 marks, then this will carry 1 marks each and this part will carry 1 mark, this part. So in that case, you have to decide and try to reduce few steps. Like you can write this one and after that you can directly write this one. Okay. Now here are few standard formulae of compound interest. We use them while doing most of our sums. A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole to the power N, where N is a number of periods. It's the same as time only. Now compound interest half yearly, rate by 2 divided by 100, 2N. And quarterly is R by 4 by 100, 4N. This is the difference. Now a basic change comes when time is in fractions, say A, B by C, years. So suppose if A is 2 and B by C is 2 by 3, then 1 plus R by 100 whole to the power 2, and here it will be 1 plus 2 by 3, I have already said. So 2R by 3 means B will be 2, C will be 3, 2R by 3 into 100. Now successive rates, this is a standard formula. If rate is different for different years, this formula you have to use. And remember, for a certain sum of money at a given rate and for a certain period of time, the compound interest quarterly is the highest. Then comes compound interest half yearly, then comes compound interest normal, and then comes the simple interest. Means the simple interest is the lowest. And you have to revise few laws of indices. That is, if x to the power a is equal to x to the power b, then a is equal to b, since bases are equal, base xx, both are equal. And if x to the power a is equal to y to the power b, then x equal to y, since powers are equal, a. Now these are few laws of indices which you will require in compound interest while doing the sums with formulae.